2,590 pounds, 2,590 here at Haywood RV of Coldwater, Michigan, coming in Roger Niner Niner. This is a new floor plan from Rockwood, not necessarily a new floor plan in the market, but as always, when Rockwood says they're going to do something, it's best to just get out of the way because they're pretty much going to just run over anybody else that does it. They're They're pretty much the very best at what they do. So, there was another manufacturer that had an A-frame like this, but they had a canvas pop-up, and I always thought it was so stupid. Why would you take a pop-up that was designed to have no canvas and then reintroduce soft-sided material to it? It's just not bright. Well, Rockwood agreed, so they just didn't do it like that. They did it hard-sided, and it's funny. The other brand, they had to go hard-sided overnight because they couldn't sell their model sitting next to this thing. So this is the high wall series of Rockwood A-frames. This is the bigger series. It is essentially 6 inches bigger in pretty much every way as compared to the normal Rockwood A-frames, which is funny because those are considered a high wall pop-up. So this is a higher than high wall pop-up. If at any point you like what you see, you want to learn more, you have questions, God forbid you pick up the phone and give a living, breathing human being a call, but short of that, I leave you a link in the video description right down here that says check for price and availability. You're one click away from answering questions like, what is the price? What are the holding tank capacities? How long is it? Those are easy things that you can answer right there, and I can't carry a spec sheet with me everywhere, so let's get dug in. Looks weird. It's cool. And this thing, it's like Robin Thicke. It's got some blurred lines. It mixes the line between pop-up camper and fold-down travel trailer. It's somewhere in between, and more so than any other A-frame has ever been. Let me explain what I mean by that. Real quick, I want to mention, no, this is not how the tires normally sit here. When these things ship, they ship on a double-decker flatbed. They ship 6 at a time. We order in huge bulk, so you save in huge bulk. That's kind of how you make the good deals happen in this business. But these big tires make it sit too high to ride on that double decker. So it ships with this teeny tiny little like 12-inch shipping tire. And then when we actually get it checked in and ready, the big tire with the beautiful aluminum wheel goes on there. So now you understand. And again, that's a travel trailer thing though. That's not a pop-up tire. That's a big travel trailer radial tire. This rides on a independent Torflex axle, so the wheels have more vertical travel and shock absorption than anything else. That's unmatched in this class. They give you a very cool, because it is so big, what they didn't want you to do is, like, not everyone's as tall as me. I can reach down in here and I can reach the bottom of the storage trunk, but not everybody can. The average person's a little shorter than me. I'm taller than the average bear. Hey, boo-boo! And, so they give you like a two-stage double-decker storage here. You've got a huge chunk in this like storage trough thing that pulls out, and it can pull all the way out. That's what these handles are for. You can grab it and carry it around where you want. Now they do still have storage, like you'll see, normally this would be under a dinette on most models. This is actually under a front kitchen. That's another cool thing. This gives you a bigger kitchen, which is something A-frames usually did not have, as good kitchen space. So they let you segregate your storage. Now, blurring the lines between pop-up and travel trailer, we have a traditional travel trailer dual propane tank system with an automatic changeover regulator. Pop-ups usually have only a single propane tank. Actually, small travel trailers only have a single propane tank. So this goes up and above beyond there. As we come over here, again, more outside storage, because more storage is never the wrong answer. If the question is ever, should we? The answer is yes, if the question is storage. Outside utility shower does connect to the water heater, so you can have a handy little outside rinse-off station. Very cool if you're going to go like primitive camping. We've got a roughly 11 gallon per hour water heater. It's gas only, but it is automatic ignition, so you're not going to come out here with like a matchstick to light that sucker. We do have front and rear scissor jacks. A lot of pop-ups have just single leg stab jacks, so that's another travel trailer feature they have here in a pop-up camper. What's nice is Rockwood does that on pretty much all their pop-ups. They have great stabilization once you're set there. This is the back access panel to the three-way fridge. So you've got 12 volt, 110 electric power, meaning park power or shore power as it's often called, and then propane. In English, that means cold, colder, coldest. They'll all do fine. It's just propane's gonna keep things the most cold effectively. This big black bar right here and that motor down there, that is your power lift. This has a power roof lift. The angled sides go up together. This the motor connects to this wall. This wall lifts, and as it does, it pushes the other wall up, just because, you know, physics says that two things cannot occupy the same space at the same time, so it moves out of the way. Then the side walls that we're looking at with the diamond shaped like home base looking window here, those are easy lift. This is a laminated, lightweight product that's very easy to manage. I'm in some bad sun here, so let me get in a little bit closer. This is normally a very awkward storage space below the bed, so they made the storage come to you with another one of those handy little pull-out sort of trough things there. These are also very easily towed for a couple reasons. One, it's not as wide as your vehicle, or at worst, it is equally wide as your vehicle, so you can see around it. You're not gonna catch extra headwind from having wing out stick out past your vehicle. You can see around it when you're changing lanes. It's easier to spot when you're parking. I always recommend you park with a spotter if you're backing up, but sometimes you can't, so this is easier. The other thing is, it's low profile. It is lower riding than your vehicle, even here on the high wall model. So you get to use your rear view mirror, which is something I like. Every year when I hook up to my trailer, I'm like, oh gosh, because I'm always, it screws me up. I don't realize how much I use my rear view mirror. I tend to use that before I use my side mirrors, and you have to retrain yourself on the fly. You don't have to do that here. You don't get the big bucking headwinds. It's not a problem. Big storage below the bed, and you'll notice that it comes with a handy little porta potty. So if you do have that late night emergency use, you do have a late night emergency system. And that big box right there, that is the RVQ grill that mounts over here. The storage below the bed is big enough to hold a porta potty, an RVQ grill, and then some. It's pretty impressive stuff. And Rockwood, just like their biggest fifth wheels, it still comes with a little utility table here. And what's neat is this is a freestanding table. This is kind of what I call left-handed mode right now. You'd put the grill there, you'd flip stuff, then you'd set it down on the left side. You can shift this around. Doesn't matter if you're right or left-handed. It's symmetrical, so it's easy to use that way. They're not symmetrical, interchangeable. Wrong word. Pop-ups usually don't have a bigger entry handle either. You know, a big fancy expensive pop-up might have an outside speaker system, and that's what's funny. This runs about the same money as one of those giant oversized pop-up campers with all the big amenities they come with. Has all the same stuff, but it sets up in seconds. You can get this thing, even with the extra steps required for the, what's that called, a dormer, with the extra lift roof here, whatever you want to call it, it still sets up in, I don't know, a minute if you're kind of new at it. It's not hard to do, kids. Stepping inside, I like the little breeze through window in the entry door as well. The lighting inside, all LED. And that's actually one of the things I noticed about this model specifically. Because they had the extra room up in here, they could add some extra lighting. Now, what's really cool is this is built exactly like all the other Rockwoods. It's a fully laminated aluminum frame product. So it's built exactly like their big fifth wheels. Let's go ahead and look at the business end of this thing, because this is the part that you really haven't seen. The back part of the trailer is very similar to what you've seen before. I like laying on these beds. They're not bad. Neat thing, actually, when you're laying on these beds, you don't feel like you're trapped. Other than the fact that this skylight is filthy right now from shipping, you're looking up at the sky. At night, if you're sleeping on the inside wall bunk like this, you don't feel like you're trapped in, and you do have a privacy shade here if you feel like someone's staring at you. Big windows with cross breeze, window with cross breeze, window with cross breeze. You get great airflow in here. So the whole point of this is that it adds a stand-up front kitchen, and it is literally a stand-up front kitchen. Now, there's a little lip that I ducked under back here, but I can stand here comfortably. I can be on my toes. My head just kisses the roof right here. I can stand here, wash my hands, make my bacon and eggs. I've got all kinds of crazy good prep space up here. That is something this floor plan has in oodles. It's got more countertop space than some fifth wheels I've seen. You've also got excellent storage capacity going on. All kinds of good drawer space in here, and that is something pop-ups are not known for. How many people have ever said, oh man, I bought, you know, a pop-up because it just had a ton of drawers? It doesn't happen, because pop-ups don't usually have a lot of drawers. But again, this is sort of a pop-up. It's sort of a travel trailer. It's sort of both. Look at those kitchen. I just noticed those appliance outlets staring me right in the face here. That's awesome. And they're GFCI protected, or GFI as it tends to mostly be called, but long story short, you're not going to electrocute yourself and start a fire. Now, to maximize prep space, they gave it sort of like a truck camper fold down sink and stove, but this is tempered glass. It can be used, stuff can set on it, and the sink, you don't have to, like, I've seen some pop-up campers where you have to, like, screw the faucet on and off. You're going to forget eventually, and you're going to break it. You don't have to do that here. You don't even have to put the sink head down. It just kind of does it for you automatically. I think that pretty much covers the front. Pretty simple, straightforward. Let me flip around back here. Dinette can fold down into an extra little bonus sleeper for the grandbabies if they come along. Two if they're real small and sleeping nose to toes, but most of the time, if you sleep anyone extra in here, it's going to be just a single. Now, we've got a heated mattress in the back, and this big black box down here is something I always like to talk about because people, these are still newish in the RV business. It's called a Cool Cat. It's a bi-directional heat pump. What that means in English is picture in your brain the window-mounted air conditioner you install in your home. It blows cold air in, and it splits that air and sends the hot air out. This does the same thing, except you can flip it. So it can pump hot air inside if you want. So that's an electric heater or an electric air conditioner, whichever you want. Now, it has a certain temp range that it works within, but it's something like 36 to 102 degrees. So basically, if you're camping, you're fine. Now, if it's snowy Arctic winter camping outside, that's when we like to add the propane furnace to help this thing so that you do have a supplementary heat source. You actually have two heaters in this. And if you are dry camping and you want airflow, we like to put in the bigger Max Air Fan. I think that's actually finally rolled over into the standard equipment complement. People ask all the time, what is that? It's just a clothes hanger, basically. Just gives you a place to hang some shirts since you don't have the physical space to do normal wardrobes in here. We talked about the skylight on that rear thing there. The bed is on an easy strut lift, so that can lift right up. I love all the prep space here. You know, the extra countertop space, there's no such thing as too much countertop or cabinet space, and they've done a good job of that in here, giving you lots of it. By the way, that one thermostat controls all of your heating and cooling systems except the 12-volt fan up here. That's the only thing that'll be manually operated. And again, like a travel trailer, we've got a microwave, we've got TV hookups, we've got all those fun little things like air conditioning that a normal pop-up doesn't have. Now, this is a little bit bigger and heavier than some of the other, well, most other pop-ups out there for certain. But, it is significantly lighter, less weight, less money, less towing problems than a traditional travel trailer. So if you're looking for that ease of simplicity, if you're looking for something you can store in your garage, oh my Lanta, this is the one. Give us a call, learn more, 800-256-5196. We're Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. We've been one of, if not the very largest pop-up dealer in the state of Michigan for like the last four or five seasons in a row. We sell a lot of pop-ups, guys, and Rockwood's one of our premier lines here. We carry a couple different brands, and this is by far and away the best-selling series that we have for good reason. They just have just fantastic fit, finish, quality control, and customer backing. The rare time that we do need to call on them for some kind of warranty issue, they back their stuff. They know they're not necessarily the dollar cheapest option, and they stand behind their work. The average worker at Rockwood's been there for like 12 or 14 years. That's unprecedented almost in this business. It's incredible. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.